Today, let's explore a little bit of the history of the ocean. So we need to know a little bit of history. Any subject that you are going to learn, the history also very important. Right? When you talk about the history of the ocean, people have been using ocean for a long period of time, as we already know. But like the exploration in the ocean has taken place in several stages. Like in the early time, there had been some ocean explorations, not like oceanographic study, but more like exploring the areas which have not been discovered before. කලින් හම්බුන නැත්නම් හොයාගෙන ගිය explorations තමයි ශ්‍රලං කරේ. These are the ocean exploration in the early time. Especially the some island nations like Polynesians. Polynesia වහලා තියෙන Polynesian කියලා කියන්නේ තමයි Pacific islands කීපයක්. Papua New Guinea and then can be out of the Pacific Polynesian islands keep up for near French Polynesia killer you know some other is it translate idea that you know me bolu ta unda ko mude explorations mulma kare atta na but later the api ahala thina yanna ne me Puerto Dominicas Vasco da Gama sarkari na mahala thina ne Ferdinand Magellan Nikola Tamai, Mulma Kalin explorations there, right? So the other one who did the earliest exploration in the ocean, looking for new land, right? So the first scientific investigation already, at least with some scientific explorations began after Captain James Cook. I think you have heard about Captain James Cook. He's the one who found the Australia, right? That Australia, why I got that name? Even the Australia, I think, na, era timing so tedious. But for the Western world, they didn't know there was something called Australia. So the Captain James Cook, he's the one who discovered the Australia. That's why the There are even university in Australia. James Cook University. I was graduated from that university as well. Right. Others are maybe not very familiar to you. Matthew Fontaine, Murray, but you know Charles Darwin. And the last one is the Fridtjof Nansen. Right. If you remember last week in your practical session, the They were talking about the Nansen bottle, or Nansen water sample, right? So that's his intervention. So it's invention, actually, Fridtjof Nansen. And thereafter, before the modern oceanography, in real oceanographic studies was started after like a lot of technological development, and some of the expeditions are the Trieste. If you remember last week, I showed you a metal spear. Two Navy divers who put it in a some sort of a spherical iron pole, and they were deep in the deepest point of Earth, and that expedition called the Trieste. And thereafter, the James Cameron's expedition, that is called the Deep Sea Challenger expedition. So these are more modern form of scientific investigation, right? So there are a lot of history actually, in this the timeline. You're given a lot of the history. You don't have to. Remember these things, right? Just to give an idea, right? You just have get an idea about what has been done in the history. For that purpose only, right? You don't have to remember this timeline. And this is the Magellan's voyage, what we call the circumglobal, right? Circumglobal voyages. Loke Vategiya Charikava in 1500 by Magellan. මොකද මේ කතන්දර අහලා ඇති නේ නේද මගලන් ඉතිමට වල මගදී මගලන් නරුණා ඊට පස්සේ මේ ඉතිරියයි තමයි අතර මේක කම්ප්ලීට් කරේ බට that voyage the captain is the Magellan so it is one of the earliest explorations but and then actually the scientific explorations began especially the like a lot of countries especially the western countries they started exploring the oceans right in 1830 United US exploration or ocean exploration and thereafter the well known exploration by Charles Darwin right, that is the exploration by HMS Beagle So remember that Charles Darwin is not really an oceanographer, right? He's a biologist, or actually he's a natural historian rather. So Bahavika Itihasajne, not really an oceanographer, but more naturalist, right? But there had been some scientific investigation during his voyage. With other scientists, other people who was involved in this expedition, but in really the actual oceanographic expedition was the expedition from what we call the HMS Challenger, right? That was in 1872, then 150 years now. It's called HMS Challenger. And that is where the more scientific activity, what we call the descriptive oceanography, right? That the ship or the vessel actually had some scientific instrument to explore the ocean. Right? This is the one who found the deepest point on Earth, and they have done a lot of scientific experiments from that. HMS Challenger, right? මේ නැව් වලට මේ එක එක නම් දාලා තියෙනවා ඒක පේනවා නේද HMS එක එක සමහර SS කියලා තියෙනවා මේ කවුගේ දවසට නැව් වල නම් කියනවා මේ HMS කියන එක තියෙන ගක්ලාට මේ අවුරුදු දන්නවද මොකද මේ HMS කියන්නේ That's come from the British Royal name, right? Her Majesty's ship, right? Her Majesty's ship, right? All right. then the Charles Darwin's voyage that we discussed before, but. As I mentioned, the Challenger was the more scientific expedition because they have done a lot of sampling in the ocean. And you see some of the images, rather the top one is actually a drawing of that Challenger ship, which really rather a sail. And you see how they measure the depth, the ocean depth. අපි කරනවා කි තමයි මොන හරි බරක් cables වලට ගහලා ඒක පස්සලා තමයි බලුවේ මේ ගැඹුරු කොච්චරද කියලා. පේනවා ඇති මේ දකුණු පැත්තේ තියෙන පින්තූරේ කොච්චර මේ cable තියෙනවද කියලා. So they had no any idea how deep it is. So they prepared with a lot of cables which ran all over the ship, right? You know, ballast කියලා තමයි මේ මේ අපිට මරියානා ආගාදේ මේ හුඟක් දේවල් හොයාගත්තේ ඇත්තටම පළවෙනි වතාවට මෙන්න මේ එක්ස්පෙඩිෂන් වල. Right. and look at this, some drawings of that same ship. You see how long it is. There have been some laboratories inside as well. Do a lot of physical and chemical as well as biological sampling. And also, since it's a long voyage, several years, so they had everything inside the ship to do a lot of analysis. And look at the top left image. Reversing water bottle. You see the original, this is how this original design came from. And even today, they use still pretty much same sort of a design. Right? And look at these drawings. They are original drawings of the people on that ship. Drawings and chemical analysis. So now you can compare with our drawings now. Drawings, very, very complex drawings. So it's an indication of how diligent they are, how they look at this. Right? It's a long time ago, without even a proper magnifying glasses. So they had these drawings nicely done. Right? So that they're very, very, very diligent on that particular subject. All right, so that's the bit of his history, but not finished yet. Other than that, there had been a lot of other expedition, like a polar expedition, because by that time, no one has been to the polar region because it's the harsh weather conditions. It's so hard to be in the polar region, but there had been a separate expedition in the polar regions for the polar explorations, and the other one is the Meteor expedition, where they used some optical devices like the magnifying glasses and the microscope like that, right? And there was Atlantis looking for the mid-oceanic or the Atlantic Ridge. I will later tell you what it is. And then the other one is the Trieste, which already you know. The Glamour Challenger, that's where the first time they used the computer. This is the Meteor expedition on your left, where they use some echo sounders for the first time, right? So until then, you had to use some weight to test the depth, but in this case, they have already invented the echo sounders to measure the depth easily and quickly. In the lab classes or even in the field classes, I can show you some of the, like even we have handheld or the mobile echo sounders where you can measure the depth. We couldn't show you in the last week since we didn't want to do too many instruments for the first day. But later on, I can show you very small devices are there to measure the depth. And the right side is it's a Glamour Challenger. You see, like a drilling ship, right? This is capable of drilling the ocean deep areas for looking for minerals and oil. Towards the end, we can discuss a bit more on these kind of things of exploration, right? And here you can see this the use of echo sounders. Now, they have been the echo sounders are widely used in the oceanographic studies. Not only that, even for fisheries purposes, for detecting fish, but also the ocean depths and what kind of habitats are there. You can see from this echo sound. Echo sound reactala, patuleti ne, swabhave kena pe sahen adhasa kan, patule ne mund. Maalu inna tempa wo haga na kare echo sounders pauch karan. අර මං කලින් කිව්වා අපි ළඟ තියෙන echo sound එකේ යම් කිසි idea එකක් ගන්න පුළුවන් කොයි තැන් වලද මාළු ඉන්නේ ඒ වගේ දේවල් right but there are more advanced versions where you can really identify the availability of fish right so all these the development in the oceanography with the development of technology right? and also there are few people who were involved in the development of oceanography as well as marine science, particularly the biological part as well. especially the latter part of the 20th century. Has anyone heard about this person called the Rachel Carson? අහලා තියෙනවද එහෙම කෙනෙක් ගැන රේචල් කාසන් ගැන කවුරුත් නැත් මේ සයිලන්ට් ස්ප්‍රින්ග් කියලා පොතක් ගැන අහලා නැද්ද කවුද
නෑ සර්
නෑ ඕකේ ගුඩ් කෙනෙක්ලි නෑ කියපේ කොහොමද මම අහලා තිබුණේ නෑ ටෙම්පස් එකේ නෝට් එකකින් ගන්න Nothing to worry about, right? Me silent spring ke na poten tamai attar mo ye me uralti no nara DDT ye wake persisting organic table ye visheshi ma rasayanika dravya picture ka ye me ke ne tana se hata gana hata dekhi wale ma kare silent spring ke pata dibe ita kalin me chemicals sal vasen parch karana gatta loke प्रश्न लोके පෙරලියක් කරපු එකක් අලුතෙන් හිතන්න පෙරමුණ කර මේ දවස්වල තියෙන ඕගනික් කාබනික පොහොර ගැන කතාවක් කියන්නේ ඒකෙන් නම් මෙච්චර පෙරලියක් වුණ නෑ හැබැයි මේක ලෝකෙම ලොකු වෙනසක් කරපු කතාව ඔයගොල්ලෝ නිකන් Google එකට ගිහින් බලන්න silent spring කියලා so Rachel Carson is you can see the when she was young and she's older than she was a marine biologist, right? But she was so famous because of this particular book, and there's another very important person in the ocean discoveries. That is the Jack Cousteau. Or you might have given him Jack. Ke la kiwa teke baan kiye la pihe. And Cousteau, he's actually a French person. A French namak me, by a U.S. related kine. He's well known for the invention of the scuba, pure diving kela kiel ne diving world pouch kena gear scuba diving gear scuba. scuba කියල කියන්නේ self contained underwater breathing apparatus කියන එකයි self contained underwater breathing apparatus කියන එක. තමයි ස්කූබා කියලා හදලා තියෙන්නේ. يعني තනියෙන් කෙනෙකුට වෙන උදව්වක් නැතුව තනියෙන් කෙනෙකුට වතුරට යන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්නේ මේ ඩෙවලොප් කරේ අපිටම මේ මේ චෙක් ටෙස්ට් තමයි අලුත්ම තාක්ෂණයක් පාවිච්චි කරලා. රයිට් තමයි ඇක්වලන් කියන්නේ බ්‍රෑන්ඩ් එකකින් පස්සේ ඇත්තටම යා කමර්ෂලයිස් කරා මේක. ඇක්වලන් කියන්නේ තාමත් ලෝකයේ තියෙන ජනප්‍රියම මේ ඩයිවිං ඉක්විප්මන්ට් හදන කම්පැනි එක. Percy's invention. He is not just an explorer or inventor, but he is a naval officer, explorer, he is a filmmaker. There's a very famous documentaries from him. Me patule thiyenne pallaya pinthura wage thiyenne age documentaries ekata. Sorry, system එකේ මම අකර ප්‍රශ්නයක් වුණා. ඔබට මගේ screen එක පේනව නේද? මේ ලාවට තමයි system එක ඉසීට ගොමන් පොඩි ප්‍රශ්න එනවා. Right. All right. So I was talking about this Jack Cousteau. He invented the scuba, but also he's a filmmaker, actually more documentary maker, and he's an author. There are several books from him. You see the Ocean World, The Living Sea. Like you can Google, and there are several books that he has written, and also he's like a there are a lot of sayings from him. Like you see here. From birth, man carries the weight of gravity of his shoulders. He is bolted to the earth, but man has only to sink beneath the surface and he is free. Right, so that's what he said after inventing this scuba gear. Right, freely sink. අපි කියන්නේ අපි කොහේ හරි තැනකට පොළවේ නම් කොහේ හරි තැනකට ඇවිල්ලා නේ. හැබැයි මේ diving gear පාවිච්චි කරලා කෙනෙකුට පාවෙන්න පුළුවන් ඇත්තටම අර ඇස්ට්‍රොනෝට්ස්ලා අභ්‍යවකාශයේදී පාවෙන්නේ ඒ වගේ අර න්‍යූට්‍රල් බැලන්ස් එකක් පියගත්තම නැත්තම් අපේ මේ අපේ වේට් එකයි අපේ ඝනත්වයට එරෙහිව තියෙනවනේ උඩුකුම් තෙරපුම අනේ දෙක බැලන්ස් කරොත් එහෙම අපිට පාවෙන්න පුළුවන්. So that's how actually that's what the scuba diving do. They keep the neutral buoyancy or positive or negative buoyancy. Positive buoyancy on the surface එකට එනවා. Negative buoyancy buoyancy එකක් උනත් පතුලට එනවා. And if you keep the neutral buoyancy, you can free float anywhere, just like a helicopter. ඉදහසේ පාවි පාවි ඉන්න පුළුවන් පොඩි පින්ස් හරි අතු ගහලා ඉන්න උනම් ලෙවල් එක වෙනස් කරන්න අදවයිස් උල් ෆ්ලෝට් රයිට් සෝ දැට්ස් ది థియరీ అబౌట్ ది న్యూట్రల్ బాయన్స్ ఇన్ ది వాటర్ రైట్ సో వి విల్ ఎక్స్‌ప్లెయిన్ దిస్ థింగ్స్ లేటర్ రైట్ అండ్ దేర్ ఇస్ అనదర్ వెల్ నోన్ ఫిగర్ ఆర్ ది పర్సన్ అండ్ షి ఇస్ ది సిల్వియా ఎర్ల్ ఐ థింక్ ఐ మెన్షన్ లాస్ట్ వీక్ యాస్ వెల్ One of the well-known marine explorer, marine biologist actually. Again, you can Google about her, but she's the like one of the living legends. She's still living. You see her more than 7,000 hours underwater. Pedal balan visi atare. Almost that was 290ක් උතර. ඒ කියන්නේ that was 290ක් උතර මුහුද යට ඉඳලා තියෙනවා. ඒක ලයිෆ් ස්ටයිල්. ඉතින් නැත්තම් right so the other back, you know, again, it's a long journey, right? 7,000 hours on the water. It's a really a remarkable thing. a woman diver who started in very early ages, and then she's an explorer. She has developed a lot of submersible devices. Sorry, मुझे पता चला कि अन्य पुराने submersibles थोड़ा develop कर लेती हूँ या क्या ना idea के दिला दी हूँ मैं इन्हें ते वाके कर मैं धारी. And also she is the one who helped the Google to add the ocean data. अभी अदर Google लोड किया हम ocean समाहर पे मतलब मुझे अटूटे अन्य पुराने Google. She is the pioneer to do that, right? So likewise, there are key figures in the history of the ocean exploration. So since you are the beginners in the ocean exploration, you need to have a little bit of a history knowledge. Yeah, say Hari Veda got hamotam. Okay, he yeah say dhanam tamai or tamani sa anagatya known. So we know how the it has been happened in the history, right? All right, that's a little bit, I mean, the very brief history of the ocean, right? There are a lot more to say, but I don't want to make things very complicated for you, especially in this early stage of your university degree, right? So with that, let's move on to the little bit further into the our subject, the oceanography. And, we need to know the boundaries, where do you, right? Where does it start and where does it end? And then what is there? Something like a little bit of the little bit about the ocean. Right? so first thing is the terms that we use, the ocean versus sea, right? So we quite often we use the two terms, the ocean and sea. What difference is there? Mukatte venasa me the ocean ekak saha sea kiyanne ki venasa. Can anyone tell me what is the ocean? What is an ocean and what is a sea? Is same or something different? Right.
Sea ekak ocean eke part ekak vidihata kiyanna puluwanda?
Very right.
Ocean is a collection of many seas.
All right. Yeah. Very true. So it's all about the ocean. Actually, we have the ocean, but just to identify different areas in the ocean, we use the term the sea. Like it's the Indian Ocean, but around the seas around Sri Lanka, we call it the Sri Lankan Sea. Right? We don't call it the Sri Lankan Ocean. It's the Indian Ocean, right? But it's when it's around the Indian Sea. So just to recognize different areas in the ocean, we call the sea, right? And the other one is the how many seas are there? There are a lot of confusion and a lot of information about like how many oceans are there. And there may be like very often some people call these seven seas. අපි එච්චරම නම් මේකට ෆැමිලියර් නැනවත ඉංග්‍රීසි හිස්ටරි එකේ මේ seven seas කියන වචනේ නිතර තියෙන එක. එක එක දේවල් වලට පාවිච්චි කරනවා මේ seven seas කියලා. Sailing the seven seas කියන සමහරට sailors ලා පාවිච්චි කරන දෙයක් නිකන් ලෝකේ deadly මුහුදු හතක් කියනවා දැන් ඒ භයානක මුහුදු හතේ මේ sailing කරන එක ගැන කතා කරලා sailors ලා ඒ ගැන කතා කරලා ඉතින් අපිට ඇත්තටම මුහුදු හතක් ගැන සමහර අය කතා කරනවා and there's even song Google කරලා බලන්න Sailing in the Seven Seas කියලා there's a very very famous song as well, right? So this term has different meanings, but how many seas are there actually? I think this in the world map you can see some the oceans, right? In the top you have this Arctic Ocean, in the Atlantic Ocean, the Pacific Ocean, and the Indian Ocean, as well as the Southern Ocean, or the often we call this as an Antarctic Ocean, right? Then we have another term, the Southern Ocean, again, but the common term is the Antarctic Ocean, right? And in the Atlantic Ocean, of course, you can North Atlantic and South Atlantic. You can divide if you want, right? The North Pacific and South Pacific, but right? As you can see, these all these are arbitrary lines. Meva me oceans api me iri andala me iri wen karanna puluwan ona ikkada kisima scientific hetuwak naha, but they are all the same, right? They are all interconnected. There is no any boundaries for the ocean. They are all interconnected, right? We'll talk about these things later on, just to pretty much the same thing. But as the oceanographers, if you are an oceanographer, they particularly talk about actually four oceans in the world, right? It can be five, sometimes seven, no matter, right? It depends on how you look at it, but for the oceanographers there are actually four large ocean basins, right? In terms of the size as well as the depth, if you consider these two, the size, the volume, as well as the depth, if you consider these things, there are actually four oceans: that the Pacific Ocean, the largest one, the Atlantic Ocean, the second largest, the third largest, the Indian Ocean, and the Arctic Ocean. Now what happened to the other one, Antarctic, right? Why is that, right? I'll show you later on the sizes of these different oceans in the world. Why we just call about the four different four, or we identify only four oceans in the world. And then there's another one interesting thing to talk about. That is the if someone asks from you, so what is the highest mountain in the world? The Everest, right? Which is true. Until you start learning oceanography, this is true. But someone who knows oceanography, this is not true, really true. කවදාවත් අහලා තිබුණේ නැහැ එහෙමනේ මේ කතාව බොරු කියලා. Right, here you go. This is මේ බොටම් එකේ තියෙන කඳුවැටි ලෝකයේ තියෙන ප්‍රධාන කඳු කීපයක් වෙන්නලා තියෙන ඔක්කොම නෙවෙයි. माउंट एवरेस्ट के तीन पत्ती के लिए हमें हिमालय एवरेस्ट इज दी एपेक्स राइट इट्स 8848 मीटर्स राइट बट देयर इज अनदर माउंटेन इन हवाई 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 द्वीप तीन नहीं हवाई ओके सुविशेष द्वीप हवाई පස්සේ කතා කරමු කොහොමද මේ හවායි උපත් වෙන හැදුනේ කියලා. මේ ඇත්තටම මේ මුහුදු පතුලේ ඉඳන් ගත්තොත් එහෙනම් අර මේ මුහුදු මට්ටමේ ඉඳන් නම් ඇත්තටම මීටර් 4000 ගණක් තියෙනවා. whereas the Mount Everest 8800. But if you look at from the bottom, actually the major portion of this the mountain is actually underwater. You can see here, right? The biggest part of this mountain actually underwater. It's coming from the sea floor, right? And it's over 10,000 meters. So whereas the Everest is 8,800, nearly 2,000 meters higher than the Mount Everest. So that is something you've never heard about, right? On your left side top, you see that the mount here. Monarch here in Hawaii. As you can see, it's not really, when you look at from the base, it's not really very high. Like it's from the sea bottom. Now, how are you going to say about the okay? So, now, then, it's the Tau Prashan Kahan, you know, the Patuda in the under, Mudu Matan in the. Of course, if it is from the sea level, it is Everest. It is, but if you consider from the sea floor, it's going to be a definitely the Mount Kea, right? So that's something unique. So these are the comparison of the different oceans relative volumes. Now you see the Pacific, how many square miles and the percentage, like the half of the world's oceans actually is the Pacific Ocean, right? Exactly half of the ocean is Pacific, then the Atlantic. The Indian Ocean is the third largest, 20% area. Yes, area on the volume. Then the fourth one is the Arctic, with this much of square miles. You see, it's less than 1%. Arctic Ocean still less than 1% of the area of the oceans, and that's one of the reasons why the Antarctic is not considered as a major ocean basin. It's maybe 0.000 something. It's almost negligible compared to the other oceans. Right? So there's no big ocean basin compared to the other. And you can see a much better comparison here. And this is another unique thing. Hari, maine api then samanyen science karana api hamoma samanyen graph andiddi binduwen patan gana udata andinne me aquatic karana ekata thamai suvisheshi avasthawak tiyenne api patan ganni binduwen etine pallahata thamai ape graph okkoma api issarahata me oceanographic data gana kiyaddi me igena karana ape uparima enne binduwa. So we have to talk about anything below zero. Make it clear. First, I have to call that except the mountain. Everest ke height ke kai, deepest point ke depth ke kai. Everest to the height ke toada deepest point ke depth ke vedi. Right, relative depth spend, and I mean depth spend, and I mean Pacific, Atlantic, Indian Ocean are very much similar depths, except the Arctic one, which is very shallow, right? All right, that's the basic comparison of the oceans on our planet. And here you see the comparison. This is a very good comparison of different water bodies and how the content of water in a different segment of on the earth, right? In the top, pie chart showing the amount of salt water to fresh water. 97.5 salt water to fresh water is just 2.5%. Right? So you can imagine how much seawater we have and how much fresh water we have. Right? So where is this fresh water? Right? 2.5% fresh water. Where does we get this fresh water? The majority of fresh water is as a glacier. Have you a glacier again? Almost 70%, three third of the world, the Earth's fresh water is in the glacier. Our 30%, you know, groundwater. And 0.8 to 30, you know, less than 1%. Permafrost කියලා කියනවා මේ වනම් අපි අපිට මේ සාමාන්‍යයෙන් අහපු වෙනින් permafrost glacier අපි දැකපු වෙනින් glacier ගැන අහලා තියෙනවා මේ permafrost කියලා එක මම මේ දන්නේ නැති හින්දා මෙන්න මේ පින්තූරයක් දාලා තිනවා දකුණු පැත්තේ මේ තියෙන්නේ soil වලට යට වෙලා සමහර තැන් වල මේ මිදුණු තැන් අයිස් තියෙනවා මේවට කියන permafrost කියලා මේකෙන් බලන්න surface and atmospheric water, 0.4 surface and atmospheric water. එතකොට දැන් තේරෙනවා ඇති මේ glacier වල තියෙනවා permafrost තියෙනවා ground water තියෙනවා අපිට ලේසියෙන් ගන්න පුළුවන් අපිට පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන් මේ surface water විතරයි තියෙන 0.4යි. මේ 0.4න් අපහු මේ pie chart එකේ බලන්න सोयल मॉइस्चर अट्मॉस्फेयर वेटलैंड्स रिवर्स वेटलैंड्स अट्मॉस्फेयर सोयल मॉइस्चर रिवर्स प्रमाण पृथ्वी तीन वतर वाली अखम वतर रिवर्स एंड लेक्स दशम नाउ दिस इज समथिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग दैट एक्वाटिक स्टूडेंट शुड नो राइट मी लोके तीन वतर वाली दशम बिंदु हता तम तीन अभी पावित मेकिम चाल प्रमाण Okay, I think you got some idea about the very basic things. Right on. Next, what we are going to learn is actually to understand a little bit further into the ocean, especially what are the different zones in the ocean? How we can divide the ocean into different areas? like you can see here in this images. So you can divide the ocean from the beach or the seashore or the coast towards the offshore, as like littoral zone, or the water column we can divide as the neritic and oceanic region. And again, we can divide the water column into different areas, and the sea bottom we can divide into different areas. Another thing is, based on the how much light is penetrate to the water, we can divide the ocean into different zones as well. And based on the depth, you can recognize some areas in the different depth. And as I mentioned before, the based on how much light it's penetrated, right? And there is something else. And all previous things we call the physical zone. So physically, we can divide the ocean into different area, right? Make a kaparam galu galu te or sankir na yoga pe na. Don't worry, we're going to learn very slowly about these things. Other than that, there's another zonation. It's called the political zones, right? Happy by human being, we with different national and international rules and regulations, we divide the ocean into different areas, and that's because the political zonation. For that, there are some national as well as international laws for that division, right? And that's what we are going to talk next week about the physical zonation of the ocean, right? So that's all for the day. If you have any questions or comment, you're more than welcome. So otherwise, if you have any other lectures, you can leave by now.